all these bands, these the Led Zeppelins and the Black Sabbaths and the Iron Maidens and all these, you know, white people bands, they always knew that they have a big, big following. Hello. Hello, assalamu alaikum, namaste, bonjour, hola, senoritas and senors. Today I am going to watch a video. I don't know why I'm talking in this accent, but you know, life is short, so you gotta try everything out. Today we're gonna watch Atul Khatri's stand-up on Justin Bieber concert. It's a really popular request, and I've been getting requests for a while to watch this stand-up routine. So let's go and watch Atul Khatri on Justin Bieber concert.
I've got two daughters. One of my daughters is around 18, one is around 22. My wife's in her mid-40s and she's wanting to get into her 20s. And here I'm in 49, looking like I'm in my 80s. And people keep on telling me, dude, you know, you look like the father of three girls, you look like the father of three. And I take it as a compliment, you know. Not because my wife looks young, because at this age I can, you know, successfully manage to raise three kids. It's a fucking achievement I look up to myself, you know. But guys, a few months back something happened. Something terrible happened, which I want to share with you. You know, somebody who's grown up listening to Black Sabbath, Jethro Tull, Led Zeppelin, you know, and now fucking Justin Bieber, you know, from Stairway. You don't know the lyrics of Stairway for Heaven? There's a lady who knows all that glitters is gold, and she's buying a stairway to heaven.
Please don't do that again.
And now to baby, 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 ooh. Fucking what a drop, yeah, what a drop.
What a drop, Jobata.
Where the Justin Bieber announced his concert in Dubai. And these three girls in my house went crazy. Oh my God, he's coming to Dubai. So close by. Today, I know the internet has made the world a sponsor, but is Dubai not fucking Dadar? And I, like a Sindhi, I was thinking of the lakhs of rupees in my brain, you know. And after a few months, he announced a concert in Vashi. In Navi Mumbai. And three of them went mad. Oh my God, we are so lucky. He's coming to India. As if Bhagwan Ram was coming to after 14 years. Us raat humare ghar pe rabadi bani thi ke, you know, Bhagwan Ram aaye. Justin Bieber aa rahe hai. I said, chalo, theek hai, mere paise bach gaye, you know, that is come over here. And then after a few days, you know, the tickets went on sale. I was at work at 2:30, my phone was on silent mode. Suddenly I saw fucking 40 missed calls. I called him and he's saying, buy the tickets, it'll go on sale. You know, during the 12th standard admission, they were not so worried. So I went online and I said, okay, the tickets are 5,000, 10,000, 15,000, 25,000, 70,000, and kidney and what all, you know, just keep going. What should I say? Papa, buy 15,000 rupee ticket. You know, for an artist who charges not more than 750,000 rupees for a single ticket. Paying 15,000 for somebody else's ticket, that's a bahut dil ko lagta, bahut dil ko lagta.
Jo baat hai. What is that, like 30,000 Pakistani? That's a lot, man.
But you know, the thing is, I love my daughters too much. I said, chalo, theek hai, I didn't go to Dubai, let me buy. So I bought, I said, okay, I'll buy three tickets. No, Papa, why three tickets? Even you have to come. I said, I'm not interested. Papa, how will we go to Vashi all alone? Bhanchal, y'all can go to Dubai. Can't go to Vashi. Papa, we don't know how to go to Vashi. Dubai is easy, take a flight, go to Dubai. Vashi, we don't know how to go.
Burger, bachche. Yeah.
We said North Bombay, we know where Vashi is, bacha. So I said, then my wife added only to it. No, come, no, you don't spend enough family time with us. I said, three of you, my family, not a bloody dhakkan.
Bloody dhakkan.
I said, you know, under pressure, I said, khari dunga, you know, baadu jaake black mein bech dunga.
Wow. Proper Sindhi.
You know, they called me up. Papa, we are going to H&M and Zara for shopping for the concert. I said, achha, y'all are also going to perform with him? No, Papa, how can we go to a concert with old clothes? I said, 15,000 rupees, people will be watching him, bacha, not y'all. My wife added only, no, we, I said, achha, go.
Wife added only.
I said, chalo, story khatam, now enough. One day before the show, my wife came to me with this SMS. See, look how sweet they are. They sent an Uber discount for 25%. Bastard, I paid 60,000 rupees for tickets. They should have sent a Maruti Alto second hand in that dress. The other day of the concert came, I was going to work. See, my daughters asked me, said, Papa, where are you going? I said, I'm going for work. Papa, we have to go to the concert. I said, but that's at 8 o'clock in the evening. But Papa, we have to go early. I said, why? You all have to open the stadium. You all have the keys.
Bahut typical dad joke.
No, no, Papa, we have to go early because Alan Walker is playing. I said, who's this Alan Walker? You don't know who Alan Walker is? I said, no, ask my wife. You know who Alan Walker? She's saying, yes, I know Alan Walker is. I said, Alan, who the fuck is Alan? Papa, you don't know who Alan Walker is? I said, bacha, I only know one Walker, black, gold and blue.
Jani Walker. So bad. It's a gimmick.
Then why are we going early? How the fuck do you know it's him playing? For all you know, it's DJ Dattu from Sanpara.
Yaar, ek to ye Indian jagahon ke naam jo hai na jeet jaate hain. Sanpara.
But then we had to go early. Like Chutiya, we reached there at 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Hot sun. We went over there, you know, and you know, this entire controversy broke out that Justin Bieber was lip syncing. You think that really was the problem? I'll tell you what the problem is.
Oh, he's angry.
They were selling a bottle of water there for 200 rupees. I said, chalo, theek hai, they were thirsty. I said, I'll buy a bottle. He started putting in disposable glasses, 5 of them. I said, main kidhar utha ke jaunga? Give me the bottle. He said, no, sir, bottle is not allowed in the stadium. I said, why? Because people will throw the bottle on the stage. I said, toh chutiya ho gaya ki 200 rupees ki bottle main us chutiya pe fekunga.
You would have once you found out it was a lip sync.
I've already thrown 60,000 rupees, my self-esteem, everything I've thrown.
Ek baap ka dukh.
This bottle is more precious than my children.
Right now, yes.
Ghar pe leke jaunga, glass mein engrave karke, drawing karke, 200 saal mein chaste pani piunga mein se. Lip syncing was the problem. I'll tell you what the problem was. They were selling a 6-inch subway there for 300 rupees.
Yaar, ye kya...
You know what that means? 1 inch for 50 rupees. I bought 1 6-inch, I said, you all take 1 1-inch, I'll eat 3-inch, baap tumhara hoon. Lip singing was the problem, buddy. This guy came to perform in front of 60,000 people wearing shorts, t-shirt and skeds. While my wife and daughter just started applying makeup at 6 a.m. in the morning.
Sure.
On the previous day. Wearing fucking clothes from Zara. And that guy came like this. Buddy, when the concert started, I said, you all go ahead, I'm quietly sitting here. And then my comedy fans came, oh, Mr. Khatri, you are here at the Justin Bieber concert. So embarrassing.
So embarrassing, sir.
Believer, sir, you are a believer. Say, believer, kya hoga? Sir, fans of Justin Bieber are called believers. You are a believer.
So
said,
embarrassing.
No, I'm a fan of Bahubali. I'm a Bahubali.
Well,
you know, honestly, I don't think he was lip syncing. Because from where we were, you know, we couldn't see his lips, his face, anything.
Oh.
The stage was in Vashi, we were in Airoli.
Different neighborhoods, different areas, you know. Man, Atul Khatri is like India's Louis C.K. without the sexual harassment and crazy stuff, you know. Atul Khatri has the best dad jokes. I mean, he has almost revolutionized dad jokes. I'm not saying his dad jokes are cool, they're still pretty lame. Jaise wo joke tha ke I paid 60,000 for this for the tickets, they better send a used Maruti Alto. That was such a dad joke. I mean, his dad jokes are good, but there's at the end of the day they're still dad jokes, so they're you know, inherently lame, but I enjoy listening to them kyunki iska ek perspective hai, and that perspective a lot of us desi men share that perspective, especially the ones who have a family and who are the head of their families. Bilkul wahi dukhna hai iske, bilkul wahi gham hai. Aisa lagta hai main apne abba ki baatein sun raha hu baith ke, if only my dad was as funny as he is. Isko itna personal guilt hai Justin Bieber ke concert mein jane ka, ke the way he starts his stand up routine is I did something, guys, pehle se bata raha hu, I'm sorry, mujhse ek cheez mujhse galti ho gayi. Aise bol raha tha jaise usne pata nahi kya kar diya hai, kisi ko gaadi maar di hai, kya kar diya. Turns out he went to a Justin Bieber concert, and you know what, we deserve that apology. All Atul Khatri fans deserve that apology because we did not expect Atul Khatri to go, you know, on that level. Theek hai, uski betiyan hai and his wife wants to watch Justin Bieber. Totally understandable. Ladkiyon ke mamle mein, it's totally understandable that they want to go watch Justin Bieber. Just don't argue with it, man. Just do what they want. Just give them what they want. Don't argue with it. Lekin aap khud nahi kar sakte ye. Come on. Meri hansi nahi ruk rahi thi jab wo Stairway to Heaven ke lyrics ga raha tha. I know it was meant to portray a point. It was meant to make a point, but it just sounded so bad when he was singing. Please don't do that, sir. Iska gussa itna genuine hai na apne bachcho pe bhi ke uske bachche bol rahe hai ke papa we can't go to washi alone. Aur ye itna typical hai aapke choti behne ya aapke bachche jo hai, they will act all, you know, soft and fragile when it comes to going in a local area. But you put them in a plane, send them to freaking US, send them to New York, they'll all be like, oh sure, no problem, I can go by myself. Turkey bhej do unko, you pahunch jayenge. Lekin unko bolo Nazmabad chale jao ya Washi chale jao, oh how will I go there by myself? What? I like his joke about the Alan Walker skit as well, ki ye kya naya gimmick hai, ye kya naya chudiya. Because it's all a gimmick, right? I mean, all DJs are pretty good at their jobs. All DJs make music. Aur EDM mein ab zyada raha nahi hai kuch naya karne ko. You know, dubstep aaya tha, dubstep ke baad thoda evolution aur hui us music mein. And you know, we ended up with EDM right now. And EDM ke baad ab kuch hai nahi itna zyada usme naya kuch karne ko. So what DJs do is they find new gimmicks to, you know, get their name going. Marshmello puts on a mask. Deadmau5 has done it. All DJs, popular DJs are doing it now. Kyunki it's true, he has called them out on this. What kind of new gimmick is this? Because all that is a gimmick. Nobody knows where he lives, nobody knows what he does. It's not that difficult to make that happen. Main agar Q&A video nahi karta kal, toh nobody would have known where I live and what I do. So it's not that difficult. You know what? If I would have paid 15,000 rupees or 30,000 Pakistani rupees to watch Justin Bieber in a concert, and if he would have lip-synced the whole thing, I would be really mad. Just like he said, somebody who's a fan of rock music, Jethro Tull, Led Zepp, you know, Floyd, is tarah ke band sun raha, Black Sabbath, those guys will never do that. They will never, you know, play a recording in their concerts. Their audience will kill them. They will always come out and play live music and sing live music. And that's what we like. That's what rock fans, you know, appreciate. And for somebody like Atul Khatri, I would not be surprised if he was mad about that. But he had other things to be mad about, like all the amount of money he spent on, you know, basically nothing. And all the nakhras that he has to bear from his family members. That's the funny part of it. But yeah, I would have smacked him with that $200 bottle. 200 rupee bottle. Matlab, main agar us concert mein hota, I would definitely throw that bottle on him. Kyunki what the hell, man? Tum usse, you know, you're taking a fortune from me just for the tickets and you're not even singing, goddamn. Matlab, aap wahan pe aake, sirf, you're acting like a god that, you know, I'm here and that's, you know, more than enough for you people. And, you know, live with it and be happy with it, and then you left. Even Michael Jackson would perform when he came to India. Like, come on, man. Who the hell do you think you are? Justin Bieber? Speaking of which, I think it's pretty cool, yeah, that India mein foreign bands tour so many times a year. Pakistan mein it happens really occasionally, I guess. Bryan Adams was the last big Hollywood celebrity musician jo mujhe yaad hai Pakistan mein aaya. Uske baad I think some DJs came, Diplo and those kind of people. But other than that, I haven't heard of any rock band coming to Pakistan. And another thing that I jo ki mujhe bahut tang karti hai in logo ke bare mein, it's great that I have this platform that I can, you know, talk about these things and share my opinions about these things, is all these bands, these the Led Zeppelins and the Black Sabbaths and the Iron Maidens and all these, you know, white people bands, they always knew that they have a big following in South Asia, in India, in Pakistan, in Dubai, you know, in all these countries jahan pe itne sare fans hain ke young kids like you and me who have been looking up to these guys since, you know, our teenage years, be it Rage Against the Machine, be it Audio Slave, be it any, you know, rock band. I'm just gonna talk about rock bands right now. All their lives they didn't even bother to, you know, think about these fans. All they did was their concerts in US, in Europe, and that's about it. They didn't even, you know, acknowledge their fans' existence in outside Europe or US. And now that you know, times have changed and this kind of music is not popular in US, in Europe, and Europeans and Americans are looking forward to new electronic music and rap music, and, you know, rock is dying in the West. So now they're looking for appreciation and money from those fans jinko unhone neglect kiya puri zindagi. And now that they're not even on their prime, sab budde ho gaye hain, na to live music sahi se bachta hai, na maza aata hai sunne mein live music, kyunki it's not the same. There was a time when they had to come and, you know, please us too. the fans that, you know, listen to them, that worship them like this, they never thought about it. Jab unka time tha sochne ka. And now that nobody cares about them in their own countries, they come to us, they perform in Dubai, they perform in India. And we, hum kutiyon ki tarah ja ja ke ticket khareed khareed ke wahan pe ja ke khade ho jate hain aur yun karke haath hila rahe hote hain. And the gig is horrible. Dubai mein abhi recently hua tha, Iron Maiden ka concert, ya pata nahi kiska concert. It was a shitty concert. Wo buddho ki tarah khade ho ke baja rahe hain aur theek hai, I get it, it's a legacy and, you know, I'm really happy to see them. But it pisses me off that they only thought of me when they needed money, when they got, you know, kicked out of their own fan base. Jab unki fan base mar gayi, uske baad they came looking to, you know, they came looking for us. Like that, I am never putting my money any of these, you know, bands jinke hum bachpan se fan the, and they never give a shit about us. And now that their careers are over, inke apne mulkon walon ne inko laad maar di hai, now they come looking for money towards us. Now they come to Middle East, now they come to India, now they come to South Asia. Screw that, man. Don't go to these concerts. Jitne bhi log apne prime mein aake aapke paas aate hain, aapke liye perform karte hain, support those people. But people who don't look at you as, you know, don't even acknowledge your presence, screw them. Don't go to their concerts. Don't. And especially people who lip sync, like Justin Bieber, screw them. Mera favorite joke ye tha ki when he meets his comedy fans at the concert and they straight up tell him, you're here at the Justin Bieber concert, so embarrassing. I know it's not that funny, lekin mujhe bahut funny laga ye, kyunki main bhi yahi kehta. Agar main wahan pe apne ghar walon ko leke aaya hua hota, becharon ki tarah kone mein khada hota baaki driver mardon ke saath, aur mujhe wahan pe Atul Khatri dikhta, to main bolta ki sir, aap yahan? This is so embarrassing. Are you a believer? So yeah, spot on. Jisne bhi bola tha, spot on, brother. Yeah, this was Atul Khatri's stand-up routine on Justin Bieber concert, jisme wo aaya aur apni audience ko chooza bana ke chala gaya, lip syncing karke chala gaya. Thank you, Hitansh, for requesting this, bro. I really appreciate your request and everything you do for the channel. Guys, check out Hitansh's profile. He helps out with the Facebook for our channel, and he, you know, makes a lot of memes and he does a really good job. I would like it if you guys support him and follow him on his social media. Yeah, let me know which stand-up routine you guys want me to react to next. I will see you guys tomorrow with another video. Take really good care of yourself. Shab khair.